Women don't like sandwiches.
Women love sandwiches. Your mum must have liked sandwiches.
No, she didn't like them.
Not one woman likes a sandwich. When's the last time you saw a woman buy a sandwich?
Why don't they like sandwiches?
I'm not a woman, am I? How am I supposed to know? I just know what I know, and I know they don't like sandwiches.
Wait, if women don't like sandwiches, how the fuck are there 15 or 20 different types of sandwich shops in the world? Like Pret a Manger, Starbucks, all them stupid fucking Benjis. Benjis.
It's called Benjis, isn't it? Marks and Spencer. Two blokes.
They love them as much as they love shopping.
But, you know, they don't... Well, they,
oh, well, so you're saying women don't like shopping then?
No, but they like shopping.
Sort of freak.
They like shopping, but they don't like sandwiches.
Are you a freak?
Well,
women love sandwiches and women love shopping.
They like shopping. Women like shopping, but they don't like sandwiches.
And they love sandwiches when they're shopping. Oh, yeah, there you go. I've been out with your wife and had a sandwich before. Now, explain that. Go on. I've had a sandwich with your wife down Oxford Street and then got drunk with her and hit my head on a bus.
Yeah, but you've had sandwiches. She didn't have none.
She had my sandwiches. It's a good day.
Jonathan? Are you alright?
Yeah, I'm fine.
You look like you've seen a ghost.
No, it's insane. It's crazy.
What is it? You can tell me.
Well, you know that new Lucy I fitted in the downstairs toilet?
The one you put on the other week?
Look, I know this sounds impossible, right, but it started speaking to me.
What?
At first, you know, it was just suggestions, maybe you want to do this, maybe you want to do that, but last week it started demanding that I do things. Terrible things. Like, you know, it wants me to kill. Get a knife out of the kitchen drawer, go down to the local picnic area and just kill. Kill. Kill everyone.
Well, why don't you use the upstairs loo?
I'm not going up two flights of stairs every time I want to wee.
Hang on a sec, love. Can I have your phone number?
It doesn't work. Your chat up line doesn't work.
I can go for like 10, 15 minutes saying all this bollocks about how I like you and how I really want to go out with you. I know for a fact within 15 minutes you'll give me your phone number. Give me it now.
No, try it. Just don't waste your time. You sit down, come back in 15 minutes and see if I give it to you.
Just give me it now.
No.
You will want to go?
No.
Don't be so rude. Right, give me your phone number.
No.
I'll take that.
No.
I'll pour a drink over someone's head. You know you want to see that, innit?
No.
All right, and we're getting the doorway. We'd have half hour. The kitchen, another half hour.
And then what?
Maybe the bedroom, but probably front room first. I like to do every room in the house. See?
You do what in every room in the house?
I cry. Just give me your number and I'll take you out.
No way.
What do you mean, no way?
No, okay, number one, because I don't want to. Number two, because even if you were good looking, you're still a bit of a cock.
Jonathan? What's happened?
Nothing. Nothing's happened. I'm fine.
Jonathan, tell me.
I'm fine.
Jonathan, I really think you should use the upstairs loo.
Look, I'm sorry, I'm not walking up two flights of stairs every time I want to have a wee.
Nic nowego nie miałam ci do zakomunikowania. Obecnie tak samo.
Posłuchaj, Katarzyno. Pod koniec 41 roku.
Wiem. Otrzymałam list.
Napisałem, że nie chcę, żebyście właśnie wy wychowywali mego syna. Podanym znajomych, moich przyjaciół. Otrzymałaś ten list?
Nie. Żadnego listu nie otrzymałam. Zresztą mogę cię zapewnić, że gdybym go nawet otrzymała...
Że zaledwie przed miesiącem wróciłem do kraju.
Napisałam ci, że ostatni raz był w tym mieszkaniu. Mogę cię zapewnić, że na dobrego Polaka.
Trudno. Stało się. Ale on ma 17 lat. Zaręczam cię jednak, jeżeli on żyje, to prędzej czy później mój syn będzie moim synem.
You're not seriously thinking of doing anything to Russell Turner, are you?
What? What are you talking about? Alex, I'm just writing the subtitles, so...
Look, don't take this the wrong way.
No.
But I know a very good psychotherapist who has a lot of experience with catastrophic thinking.
Yeah, that's it. Here we go. I've had this one before. As soon as someone doesn't like my artistic vision, out comes the old psychotherapy card. Look, Alex, if you don't like the whole Russell Turner stuff, don't be a coward. Just say.
No. I do. I love the Russell Turner bits. It's just that it is a children's film, and I worry that maybe it's getting a little bit dark.
No, kids love all the dark stuff. Look at Russell Dahl.
You mean Roald Dahl?
That's the fella, Russell Turner.
The thing that really annoys me with tight people, if you haven't got money to go out and have a drink, but you've got a few good mates, and you speak to them and say to them, look, I'd like to come out for a drink this weekend, I haven't got much money, can you lend me a few quid? That's fair enough, that's bang on, that's sweet, because you've asked them. What I hate is when someone comes out without telling you they've got no money. Say there's six of us that you should go to school together. Not all got loads of money, not all loaded or anything. But you ain't going to go out unless you've got money to buy a drink. Yeah?
Yeah.
You're not going to do it. But then you get one person who will purposely stand back from the bar. You call them like Captain Standback. That's what it is, Captain Standback. They'll wait till, like, say, someone's weary on it. Oh, I'm going to go now, I don't want to stay out all night. What it should be is, like, pour a drink over their head. Or stand next to them in front of a whole crowded bar of people and say, this geezer's been out of us all night, I ain't paid a penny. And you're a bit like that.
Captain Standback.
Yeah, you just said it. It's not like we're millionaires.